Hey guys, my name is Dylan, and today we're going to go over a few simple steps in post that you can take to have better voice audio in your videos. So your talent's voice will go from this to sounding something like this.
Before we start, I wanted to let you know that I've put the settings that we're about to go over in the description below to make it so that these steps are simpler. The tools we're going to use may seem confusing, but just follow the steps we take and you'll have better voice audio every time. You can even save the different settings for later use, which we'll talk about in the end. First thing I'm going to do, since my audio is a stereo track, is change the pan mode to dialogue. This will bring my voice a little more front and center and not sound so all-encompassing. The next thing we'll do is add channel EQs to our audio. A channel EQ is going to allow us to shape the sound of our audio, whether that be for individual channels or the audio as a whole. This is usually a good first step to take. Press this button over here to open it, and we're going to click Analyzer so we can see our audio waveform. This first channel EQ we're going to use as a way to buffer out the rough parts of our audio. Essentially, we're going to go through our audio frequencies to find specific frequencies that sound like trash and stand out above other frequencies. This process is called EQ sweeping, and it can also be used to find specific frequencies that you want to boost. What you're going to want to do is take one of these four frequency bells up here. Despite being different colors, it actually doesn't matter which one you take. We'll head down to this bottom value for the corresponding color and click and drag up with our mouse or trackpad to narrow up the bandwidth a tad. We'll raise this up, play our track, and sweep back and forth till we find a frequency that just sounds off.
Hey guys, my name is Dylan, and today we're going to go over a few simple steps in post that you can take to have better voice audio in your videos.
So, you hear how this frequency stands out and just sounds bad?
Better voice audio in your videos.
We're going to remove this from our track by cutting it out, so lower this to about negative 12 or so. The narrower this colored zone is, the more you can get away with lowering these. If you try and lower a range with a wide bandwidth, you're just going to be cutting out a lot of your audio, and it'll be pretty noticeable and distracting.
Hey guys, my name is Dylan, and today we're going to go over a few simple steps in post that you can...
So let's sweep again to check for more frequencies.
Hey guys, my name is Dylan, and today we're going to go over a few simple steps in post that you can take to...
Here's another one, so we'll do the same thing. Do this as many times as you need to. If you need to add on another channel EQ to EQ sweep some more, you can do that. I also forgot to mention, if you need to quickly replay the audio, press /  on your keyboard and your audio will play again from the beginning. After you've done your EQ sweeping pass, we will add another channel EQ to our audio, and we'll use this one to shape our audio as a whole. We'll first add a low pass filter and a high pass filter, which will get rid of any audio frequencies that are too high or too low, which usually aren't found in the human voice. Just click these here and drag them out a tad. This will remove any type of high-pitched noise going on in the background or the hum of some type of machine or electronic. You don't want them to start overlapping with your voice though. Next, what I'll usually do is raise the low frequencies of my voice a bit to add some richness and fullness that is soothing to hear.
Simple steps in post that you can take to have better voice audio in your video.
Generally, this will be from 100 to 200 hertz. You don't want to raise it too much because that'll cause some rumbling in your speakers, but just enough to where you think it sounds good. Something that a voice track may also benefit from is adding a slight raise to our high frequencies. These slight raises we did to our low and high frequencies are called shelving filters. So we have the low shelf here and a high shelf here. This just makes our audio sound rich and clear. The next step I usually take, and you can skip this if you need to, is add CrumplePop Echo Remover to get rid of the echo in your audio. So I'll just drag this on, I'll click this button, and I'll adjust the strength and release of the effect till I find something that works for the audio voice track.
Today we're going to go over a few simple steps in post that you can take to have better voice audio.
Now there is a way you can try and take out echo in the compressor, which is a tool that we're about to use next, but it is a lot of trial and error and I usually don't have time for that. Next up, the compressor! So the compressor will help us to bring the quieter parts of our audio to a more even level. It'll also help to lower the parts of our audio that are way too loud after those parts have gone over a certain point. And it'll help us to raise the overall volume of our audio to where we'd like. It's important to note that the values I'm going to mention are beneficial for voice audio, so if you're using a compressor for musical instruments or something like that, these values are not going to be the same. I'm not going to go in depth on what each of these does because that would take way too long. Maybe I'll make a video about that in the future, but we will just start out by doing something called zeroing out the compressor. So this is basically setting the compressor to neutral. So to zero out the compressor, we will change the threshold to zero, and all you'll do is slide up or down with your mouse or trackpad to change these dials. These dials are kind of confusing to use at first. Next, you'll change the ratio to 1:1. You'll change the attack to about 10 milliseconds, and the release to about 30 milliseconds. Now the compressor is zeroed out. So look at your input gain and play your audio. About where does your talent's voice fall?
Today we're gonna go over a few simple steps in post that you can take.
You'll take that amount, so here it's about negative 12, and we'll lower the threshold about 6 to 12 decibels less than this number. So we will do about negative 20 here. This is the point where the compressor will start kicking in. Next, we'll set the ratio either from 2:1 to 4:1. I'll set this about 2:1. We'll set the attack anywhere from 1 to 5 milliseconds, and we'll set the release from 10 to 30 milliseconds. Generally, the compressor should be reducing 3 to 10 decibels of gain, so look on this meter and check to make sure it's staying in this zone. And it looks like it is.
And today we're going to go over a few simple steps in post that you can take to have...
Next, we're going to throw a limiter on there. This will be used to even up the volume of our audio even more and give it a boost without clipping it. So the first thing we'll do is set the mode to legacy mode. We'll change the look ahead to about 4 milliseconds and the release to about 10 milliseconds. We want to increase the gain until we see the input meter start to kick in and reduce our volume about 3 to 5 decibels. So raising this up, you'll see it's starting to kick in here and we have about around 3 or 4 decibels of reduction. But since our output level is showing 0 decibels, this is too loud since we'll be adding music and possibly other forms of sound design. So we will lower our output level till our levels peak around negative 6 on the output meter.
Hey guys, my name is Dylan and today we're going to go over a few simple steps.
Let's toggle on and off our audio effects to see what we've done.
Hey guys, my name is Dylan, and today we're gonna go over a few simple steps in post that you can take.
That made a pretty huge difference. Finally, we're gonna click this Save Presets button to make sure that every time I record audio with the same mic, in the same room, with the same talent, I know I have all the effects in one preset that'll make it sound perfect. If you have a new subject, a new mic, or in a different room, you may need to adjust these settings to fit that scenario.
And that wraps it up. If this video helped you out, do me a huge favor and press the thumbs up button, leave a comment below, and make sure to subscribe if you want to continue improving as a filmmaker and editor. Have a great day.